Okay, and welcome to a possible new Let's Play. This game is called Europa Universalis 3, and I have the expansion sets up to Divine Wind, which is the latest one. And I really like this game, and I would like to do a true Let's Play, which will be just like my Industry Giant 2 LP, meaning that I ask for your suggestions as I play. I don't know what I will do, if it'll be a once a week like Industry Giant 2, or if it would be maybe bi-weekly, because I'm going to be starting back to school in September, and I don't know how much time I'm going to have, but this is a pretty awesome game, and I do enjoy it, and I think it makes for a good Let's Play, a true Let's Play. Meaning let us, meaning you and me, not just you, I play, you watch, which is most Let's Plays, right? So this is basically a war strategy game, but it's completely real world. This is a game that I have right now. I'm the Hansa, which was a kind of a Northern Germany faction. You may have heard of the Hanseatic League, so they were big traders up in this part of Europe. So I'm pretty far in this game. It's 1726. And I don't know how many hours I've played this particular race, but as you can see, I've got quite a bit of Germany, and it's probably one of the toughest campaigns, because Germany starts as just a mess. All of this, just picture all of this as all of this over here too. And all I started with was Lübeck, which is certainly one of the best territories in the game, I'm sure. And I started with Bremen, I think. I might have started with Hamburg, too. I think I had three. I think I just had these three. So anyways, I'll just show you the world. This is just kind of a preview of the game, and then I'll invite your comments if this is something that you'd like to see more of. I've got a random province down here. It was because I was at war with Brandenburg here, and I took one of their dinky little countries down here, but... Anyways, Austria is out of control, as you can see. I'll zoom out here and then it'll show the names. Russia is huge. Austria is out of control. Look, they own all of this. And there's dinky little Hungary. Spain has whipped Portugal. So if you live in Portugal, well, you were taken over and Spain owned you. Except Portugal's just down here. That's about it for Portugal. I have a bit of Africa here. I have South Africa. I have a little bit of this, and mostly because this African tribe were basically they sending spies at me all the time, so I took some of their countries, some of their provinces. I have Madagascar and some little islands here. I have this island off of India, which I don't know what it's called, and I have a couple little pieces over here of the Philippines here. Mostly for the tea, and I got a rebel there. I have to take him out. Mostly for the tea, and where was it? There's like Chinaware or something. Oh, I think it's this province that's being attacked. And I have a good chunk of North America beside the France, and there's the Hurons, who I've left alone, and France actually took over the Iroquois right here, which I did not like, but I don't want to pick a fight with France. They're kind of big. There's Britain down there. There's some more Spain. Britain. There's Britain. Ireland formed. Britain, for some reason, has Iceland, and I don't know why. Russia's into Norway and Sweden, so that's kind of annoying. Denmark has been a nobody for most of the game, too. So actually, Denmark was my vassal for quite a bit of time. So anyways, the main point, one more thing about this one, and then I'm going to show you my other games. And of course, for this Let's Play, I'll be starting a new one. There's also tons of goals you can do. And one of them that I've been trying to do, which is really difficult, is it's called Form the German Nation. And you need a whole bunch of provinces. I have just last night, got all the provinces. But I just need the cores, and the cores, after 50 years, you get a core on a province, which means like your particular nation has been in that province long enough to kind of have a populace, and the the people there have your culture and all those kind of things. So once I have all the cores, then I can finally form Germany. And so then I will no longer be called the Hansa, I'll be called Germany. So that's been my goal for this. And it takes a long time. Like the game, this game actually only goes until 18 something. I think it might be 1837 or something like that. So there is a time limit. You can't play this indefinitely, although there might be a mod that breaks. I think there is a mod that breaks that indefiniteness. Anyways, so I'm going to show you. I have another game that where I played Sweden. And I have another game where I played the Huron Indians, actually, and which sucked. But I'll show you that one. So I'll be right back. Okay, and here's my Sweden game. And the resolution might look a little better. I checked out. I just did the Hans video, and I checked out the fraps, and it was all kind of garbled, and I figured out it was because it wasn't recording in 16.9, so I switched that. So this should look a little nicer. So this is my Sweden map. Now, remember in the Hans video, I showed you there was a goal that you can become the German nation. Well, in this game, I got enough provinces to become the Scandinavian nation. So I already completed that goal. So that's why I'm not called Sweden. I'm called Scandinavia, as you can see. I took over Denmark and Norway and Finland. Actually, I prevented Finland from forming. That's what I did for this, because later, Finland, I don't think is available at the beginning of the game. Finland forms later right here, but I stopped them from forming pretty much. And look, there's no massive Russia. I think in the other game, Moscow forms Russia, but not in this game. Or maybe it was Novgorod. I'm not sure. I think it was Novgorod. They formed Russia, but not in this game. So different things that happen. Look at there, Scotland. Actually, that was, I'll get to that, actually. So as Sweden, you start as a vassal to Denmark. And so what I had to do was I had to break off my alliance with Denmark and then attack them. And I actually picked a pretty opportune time to beat up on Denmark because they were at war with somebody, I can't remember, and they were pretty weak. So I basically just took them right there. And then Norway, eventually I got rid of Norway too. So that's what I did for this map. Poland is huge in this one. Austria is tiny. And I got a couple, I think these might be allies, the Papal State. I should have mentioned in the Hans video, and I will now, I mentioned it earlier, it was just like a war strategy game. It's far more complex than that. There is an economy. There's each little province has a different commodity that they make, and taxes and production values, and there's religions. There's all kinds of buildings that you build. See, these are all the buildings that you build for each province. There's unique buildings. There's larger buildings that are really expensive. There's one of them, for example. If I built a weapons factory, I get $6 just from it alone. But if it's built in a province of copper or iron, you get double that, like all kinds of stuff. There's all kinds of politics. Where is it? Like you have advisors, for example. There's my advisors in this game. There's my economy. You could pause the video if you want to look at these longer than what I'm doing here. There's your military support limits. You can do more. It just costs you more money. There's religious edicts you can do. These are like the big ideas. Well, they're called big ideas, but they give you benefits. Like there's one there, there's one, there's another one. There's all kinds of merchant. There's COTs in this game, which are centers of trade, and you can send merchants. Notice I have zero merchants. I'll probably always have zero merchants because I like to do the economy aspect. Here's a COT. So it's a center of trade. It has a value at the center of trade, depending on how many people are trading in it. And you can send merchants to try to take them over or try to, here, I'll show you the COTs real quick. So here's COTs. Here's one that I have a monopoly in. Eventually, when you get enough technology, you can get monopolies. Oh, that one should be green, but that one is green. These are priorities of what I send merchants. So greens, merchants will be sent first, and yellow second, and red third. And if there's an X, they don't send them at all. Likely because the COT is tiny and not worth it. So that's a little tour of the economics of the game. It's crazy. So anyways, here's France. France is kind of normal. They usually form up. There's Spain. Portugal still exists. Ireland formed. Now, the reason Scotland's back is I actually destroyed Great Britain. I'm not sure why. I don't remember what happened. Oh, Great Britain, I guess they did form, but they lost a lot of territory. I don't remember exactly what happened, but I went to war with Britain, and I invaded their asses, and I took them right over, or I occupied them. I didn't take their, I didn't want their territory. I occupied them, and I took Scotland off, and Northumberland, or what did I say? Northumberland, I don't know how you pronounce that, and Wales. I released them. What happens is when you take over a new territory that someone else owns, for example, Norway, like technically this is Norway territory up here. What you can do is you can annex them and then they're yours, right? But if you get invaded and taken over, the country that took you out, they can tell you, hey, as a peace reparation, you are to release these nations. You are to release Norway. So I did that to Britain. I said, Britain, you're getting too big. So release Scotland. And they did it. They have to. If you get invaded, you kind of have to concede. So I made them release Scotland and Wales and all that. So Britain, I took Britain down to size, that's for sure. And Ireland formed, I guess. So I have Iceland, and I have this little bit, and I have a good chunk of North America, as I seem to always do, right? Just like in the other one. I also like to leave the Indians alone. So there's them here. Actually, there's the Hansa. The Hansa's actually right here. And Great Britain. Oh, Great Britain took over the, I can't remember who's here. I guess these guys, the Creeks are here. There's the Shawnee, and the Cherokee are in here too, but they got taken out. And the Hurons took out the Mohawk, or the Iroquois Indians, but oh well. So I'm not sure where else I am. Oh, I might be down here. Yeah, I do have South Africa. I usually like to take South Africa because it's a nice little, it's a nice like point between then over here. So, I have here. It's strange how I play kind of similarly here. So I have that Indian island, and I have Madagascar, of course, and that's it. I don't think I'm over here at all. There's Austria. There's some Austria places there. There's, of course, you can always play with the East. There's Wu China, and there's Ming China, and Manchu China, and Japan is a mess. And yeah, India's a mess. That's probably a tough campaign, playing India, or playing an Indian nation and then trying to form India. That'd be a tough one. There's the Middle East. Where's Iraq at? I guess they're not here. No Iraq. But there's Tripoli, for example. And there's Morocco. There's the Ottoman Empire. Actually, in my Hans, in the Hans world, the Ottomans got whooped. They got taken right out. There's massive Poland. Anyways. So here's another one, and next I'll show you my Huron game, which I remember sucked. There's technology types in this game, so you can be Western technology, or you can be Oriental technology, or you can be Muslim technology, and they are in that hierarchy, by the way. But if you start as an Aboriginal, or I don't know what you'd want to call them, there's no real politically correct term, to say they're basically technologically, I don't know what word to use, but they get in their own tech tree and it's tiny because, like, look at this, land 6, naval 5, and what am I here? Okay, so they're way reduced. So if you try to play as that country, you are impeded. Like you can't grow as quick as the Western nations. You don't have the technology, you don't have the innovation, the ideas, so you don't grow. And the basic strategy to play, well, maybe I'll get to that one. So I'll show you the Huron nation. Okay, here is my Huron nation. So here I am up here. I got to the point where I believe I can do great ideas. Yes, I do have a few great ideas. So I was able to get, for some reason I don't have it. I was able to get new territory, and now I'm not sure why. I should have to have this one here. This one to get. I guess I just need colonists. I guess I did not have this idea and able to. You need this idea. You need conquistadors and explorers to get new territory like this. I don't know what's in here. Although during the game, you also get kind of random explorations. But if you actually want a specific country or a province, you want it explored or a waterway, you will want to hire a conquistador, which is a land explorer, or an explorer, which is like a naval or water explorer. So anyways, I've got a bit more territory than normally the Indians will have, or the Huron Indians will have, just by having colonists. So, and there's actually some provinces that are called wastelands, like this one right here. So there's Winnipeg, for example, like some of these places that I guess I can't get them yet. I guess I need, well, why can't I get this one? Oh, money. Oh, okay. So here it is here, and what you do, the winning strategy, and by winning, that can mean anything you want. Like taking over the world in this game is pretty much impossible. I don't think it's possible. There could be some YouTube video out there of someone doing it, but based on the time frame of this game, I just don't think it's possible. You'd have to have humongous infamy and just not care and just go to war with everybody. By the way, infamy you get is basically the arrogance level that other countries perceive you as. If you keep taking over territory that's not justified to you get infamy. And so the higher infamy, the more of a reduction that other nations will get in their relations with you, and then they'll start hating you, and then they'll go to war with you and all that, and it's a big pain. So anyways, the way to win as an Indian nation like this one, or down in South America, for example, is you basically have to meet up with the Western nations. Like, so when they come over here, and they always do, when they come over here, you have to border a Western nation, and then you have to start switching your tech tree. And so, for example, I have, in this game, I have switched all the way to Western tech. And what that is first I had to switch to Muslim tech, then I switched to Oriental tech, and then I switched to Western tech. And each time you do that, you lose, I think it's all your stability. So your nation goes a little crazy for a bit, and there's rebel uprisings and all that kind of stuff. At the same time, you have to do military modernization. So if you switch to Muslim tech, then you have to switch to Muslim military. I'm not sure what it's exactly called, but anyways, here's one right here. So here's military modernization. Unit types change to Western. So then I would get Western infantry. So that might be musketeers at this point in time. And I don't know about 1624 if they have. I don't know what is my tech. Oh, my tech's pretty good. Yeah, it probably is. What do I have here? Yeah. So right now I have Oriental tech, and so I have like Oriental musketeer people. I don't know what exactly they are. Here they are here, quasi-bash cavalry and tercio infantry. So anyway, so then what I do is, if I meet these requirements, so I have to have a stability of at least 3. There's my government type, or this is domestic policy, I guess. I have to be near centralization. And what else was it? Ruler administrator of 7. And oh, that resists Western influence things. That will come up to try to screw you. It's like an event that pops up, and your people don't want the Western ideas or whatever like that. And if you dismiss it, you lose a crap load of stability. And oh, it's really hard to switch tech trees and switch the military. But anyways, eventually, if you get it, then this is what happens. You lose 6 stability, so you go all the way down to -3 stability, which is up here. And when you have that stability negative, those are pluses right now because, oh, those are green right now, which are benefits, only because I'm at +2 stability. But if I was at -3, those will all be negatives. So you get a lot of bad stuff, national revolt risk, and all just nasty stuff. And all that thing, all those happen to you for, if I did it right now, for 4 years, all those bad things happen. But then finally, I get Western military. And then at that point, you become a competing nation. If you don't, you basically just get colonized. If you are considered I don't know what the tech tree is called, the tech tree underneath Muslim tech. I don't know if it's here or not. I don't know what it's called, but if you have it, like let's just call it Indian tech or Aboriginal tech. If you have that tech, then other nations get a. Oh, I haven't even talked about casus bellies yet. To go to war, you need an excuse, and that excuse are called casus bellies. Here, I'll show you one. Declare war, right? Here they are. Here are excuses to go to war. They're sort of more justifications. I mean, maybe I shouldn't say excuse. Justifications to go to war. So it's conquest or it's religious liberalization, right? Because they have Indian nations, right? Because Castile or Spain took over the Shawnee. Looks like the Shawnee are up here. And they took out the Creeks, which are here. So if you are an Indian type tech tree, other nations can get colonialism, casus belli, and basically it's a no-rule casus belli. They just come in over and they can just run you over. So you have to get out of that tech tree to survive in this game. So this is a pretty difficult, I don't recommend this one to play as a let's play, playing it as an Indian nation. For instance, the first, I would say at least 12 hours of gameplay is completely boring. You're sitting here as the Huron. The Huron have this bit, and I don't know if they even have Ottawa. I think they maybe have Ottawa and this bit. And then basically at the beginning of the game, you take over the Iroquois, and then you sit there for 100, actually more than that, 200, about 250 years before the Western nations come over and start causing you trouble. And that's all you do. So it's not a very exciting game to play as the Hurons, but or to play as an Indian nation, because you're sitting doing nothing for a lot of time. Anyways, I'll just show you the rest of the world just kind of for fun. So Sweden, for some reason, has not formed a Scandinavian nation, but they may as well. I guess they need Denmark down here still. There's Castile. They took over a little bit of North Africa there. What else? There's the Congo. There's Portugal. Portugal, I find I've played this game quite a few times now. I played as an Ireland nation trying to find Ireland, and that was near impossible. That's really hard because Ireland actually starts as four separate countries, and you have to kind of, like, it's really difficult. And Britain's always right there to try to take you out, so that's pretty tough to play as well. Pretty much Portugal always colonializes out here. Ming China has, I guess, took over. There's Tibet. There's Novgorod. Looks like they're trying to form Russia. There's Lithuania. Wow, they're huge. In my Hans game, Lithuania has one single country. And Austria is tiny. So there's every time you play this game, there is a completely different world picture out there. I have not, like, even in this game as the Hurons, I would have zero influence on Europe, right? And look what's happened. For some reason, Lithuania took over a huge chunk. Where's the Ottomans? They're dinky. They're just down here. Austria is not very big, unlike my Hans game. Castile and France and Britain are pretty much guaranteed to be successful no matter what. And Sweden took over Scandinavia. It could have been Norway. It could have been Finland. It could have been Denmark, although I've never really seen Denmark as an aggressor. Where's the Hans? I guess there's the Hans. So they just did this, and that's been it. So that's one thing that's pretty awesome about this game, is that the world picture is always different, no matter however you play. So let me know what you think of this game, and let me know if you think this would be a good candidate for a true Let's Play. So let me know.